Yo, what is going on, everybody? It's Juan Solo here with A Squad Gaming, and welcome back to the channel. Thank you all so much for tuning in today for some more Ghost Recon Breakpoint. So in today's video, we're going to be talking about one of the two brand new classes that just came out last week in Title Update 2.0, and it is going to be the Echelon class. So when it comes to my personal playstyle in Ghost Recon Breakpoint, this is definitely the class for me. Up until this class released, I was constantly seeing myself using the Panther class, but when it comes to the Echelon class, it almost does every single thing better than the Panther class, other than the fact that it does not have a drone spray to hide yourself from the drones. That is the one thing that the Panther class has that no other class has, but when it comes to the actual stealth of the Echelon class, it is leaps and bounds ahead of the Panther class, other than that drone spray. But honestly, if you are careful around the drones, you don't necessarily need that. But all of that is more of a personal opinion, but we're going to be going down through all of the ins and outs of the Echelon class in today's video, as well as I will have some gameplay towards the end of the video that really showcases what the Echelon class can do. So real quick, before we jump into it, if you guys go on to enjoy the video, a like rating would be super appreciated. Also, for those of you that may be new to the channel, make sure to subscribe and turn on those post notifications so you do not miss any of my future uploads. So first things first, with the new Echelon class, you will be getting a brand new special ability, and that is with the Sonar Vision goggles. And this is pulled directly from the old Splinter Cell games, which I am a huge fan of, and it basically allows you to see enemies behind walls, and it will also mark them, and it will also disrupt drones, and that is a huge thing with Ghost Recon Breakpoint. And to actually refill this special ability, you're going to need to get kills while you are in stealth, as well as you need to get CQC kills, and this class definitely shines in that area, so it is very easy to refill up that special meter, especially if you go about doing it as you activate the skill. So if you activate the skill and you get enough stealthy kills and close range kills while the skill is active, the skill will be full and ready to use again immediately after it is over, which is definitely the way you're going to want to use this class in PvE. You're going to want to activate that skill, get as many kills while that skill is active, so you will in return get that skill right back. You have to be very efficient, but it is very fun using this class in that way, as well as you will gain access to the new shock pistol, which is silent damaging electric detonation weapon, which will shut down machines and kills unwary enemies. It will also drain enemy stamina in PvP, which is a very crucial thing. I've seen a lot of people really enjoying using the shock pistol in the PvP, as well as you rank up the Echelon class, you will gain access to some proficiencies that are specific to the Echelon class, including the Master of Shadows, which gives you a higher stealth bonus in the shadows. You also get the handgun proficiency, which will allow you to have higher damage bonus with handguns, as well as it will reduce the damage penalty to zero when it comes to putting a suppressor on your pistols. As well as if you are using the HDG pistol, you will gain access to the reflex shot, which is only accessed by using that pistol, which will auto aim with a handgun during enemy visual detection. This does have a limit to 150 meters, but it is not available in PvP. And this is something that I ran across several times and I didn't even know what it was, but if an enemy spots you and you are less than 150 meters away and you aim in with your pistol, it will immediately snap to their head, so you can quickly take that enemy down before they can alert for backup, which does seem a little cheesy sometimes, being the fact that you can kind of round a corner and have an enemy spot you can instantly headshot them. But when it comes to the Echelon class, this definitely helps with the stealth mechanic, and obviously if you get spotted, you will be able to remain stealth because you should be able to instantly headshot the enemy. So now as you rank up the Echelon class, you're going to be gaining access to those new skills. So at level 2, you're going to be getting that Master of Shadows, which is the higher stealth bonus in the shadows. At level 3, you're going to be gaining the Weapon Paint, which is Gray Python, the Echelon Emblem at level 4. You will also get the Senior Echelon title at level 5, as well as the handgun proficiency we talked about. You will get that at level 6. At level 7, you're going to be gaining access to the Echelon Karambit, which is Sam's custom Karambit knife. At level 8, you're going to be gaining access to the Echelon Elite emblem. At level 9, you will get the Master Assassin title, and at level 10, you will gain access to the Maxim 9 pistol, but you do not necessarily have to max out your Echelon class to get access to that pistol, because that pistol will also be for sale at Maria's shop in Irrawan. And speaking of that Maxim 9 pistol, here it is in all of its glory. To be honest, it's one of the coolest looking pistols in all of Ghost Recon. But the one thing that I cannot get past, I personally hate the iron sights. And with the bug in the game right now that makes it so that no matter what you do, your pistol will not be clean. As soon as you crouch in the game, your pistol is going to get covered in mud or sand, and it really looks bad. But it is a good pistol, but I would strongly recommend using the HDG, because this will allow you to gain access to that reflex shot ability. And it is one of the coolest looking pistols, and it does have a very unique sound. And not to mention, it does have some really clean glowing iron sights sights that helps really, really good depending on the situation. You can put a laser sight attachment on it, but it does kind of stray off from where you're actually aiming, so I prefer not to use it, but it is a very fun pistol to use, and you will see this showcased in the gameplay later, because I am not using a primary weapon. I am specifically using this pistol only in the new immersive mode, and you guys will be checking that out here in a second. But overall, that's pretty much going to do it for me talking. I wanted to give you guys some in-depth looks into the Echelon class, and also for those of you that have been hitting me up asking why you don't have access to those new two classes, if you don't have the year one pass, you will have to wait a week to gain access to those new classes. So I believe for those of you that purchased the Deep State DLC, as well as if you did not have the year one pass, you will not have access to these two classes, to my knowledge, until next Tuesday. But I am not 100% sure on that, but that's from what I heard. You do not gain access to these classes without the year one pass until a week after the launch of this update. But overall, that's going to do it for me talking, guys. I wanted to give you all this information on this class because it is definitely one of the most fun classes to use in Ghost Recon Breakpoint. If you enjoyed the video, you are excited about checking out the class, let me know your thoughts down below, and also don't forget to subscribe to the channel for all types of Ghost Recon Breakpoint content moving forward. But without further ado, guys, I'm going to leave you with all of this really cool stealth gameplay using the Echelon class, and I will catch you guys in the next video.
Ghost must be a hell of a guardian angel.
Wolves ain't gonna take this lying down.
That bomb really tore up the R&D center.
The whole thing got out.
Whatever that was.
I'm gonna go after it.
Cool, let's go.
Oh boy, what am I doing? There's nothing.
That's weird. I'm gonna check that out.
All right, I'm coming.
You check out the R&D center? That bomb did a number on it.
Sounds like an outcast's operation to me.
Stay alert. I think we have enemies in our sector.
Roger. We'll keep an eye out for hostiles.
Jesus!
Jesus. I got a feeling we're not alone. Okay. Okay, they're definitely here somewhere.
They were here. All right, let's go look for them.
All right, I'll tag along. Now. No. Jesus.
They're attacking!
This is not good. I'm gonna look around.
I better tag along.
You might get lost.
Now.
Shit!
Let's take a look.
Sure thing, I'll come help.